This is the H2CO3 Lewis structure, carbonic acid. Hydrogen has one valence electron. We have two hydrogens, plus four for carbon, plus six for oxygen, times three, for a total of 24 valence electrons. Whenever you see hydrogens in front of a polyatomic ion, like CO3, NO3, or SO4, it's going to be an acid, and you're going to need to put those hydrogens attached to the outside oxygens. So we'll put the carbon at the center, and we have three oxygens. We'll put three oxygens around it. And then we'll put those two H's on the outside of the oxygens. So we have a total of 24 valence electrons. We'll put two electrons between atoms to form chemical bonds. So we've used 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Then we'll form octets for each atom. 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, and 24. At this point, the hydrogens have two valence electrons each, so their outer shells are full, and the oxygens have eight valence electrons each, so they have octets. Their outer shells are full as well. However, the carbon only has six valence electrons, so it needs two more to form an octet. What we can do is take two valence electrons from this oxygen and move them to the center and share them in a double bond. By sharing the valence electrons in that double bond, oxygen has eight still, but now the carbon has eight, and we're still only using 24 valence electrons. So we've used all 24 valence electrons, and each of the atoms in H2CO3 has a full outer shell. So that's the Lewis structure for H2CO3. We could check our formal charges. If we did, we'd find that the formal charge for each atom in H2CO3 is zero, making this the Lewis structure for H2CO3. This is Dr. B, and thanks for watching.